suck at jujitsu. So what he's gonna do is he's gonna start to counter. He's gonna push me down. He's gonna try to flatten me out and stuff here. And I don't appreciate when people do that, because it makes me thinking I've been doing shit a lot harder. So today we're gonna use a series commonly known as the shoulder crunch, popularized by an okay jiu-jitsu Rio named Gordon Ryan. Some of you may have heard of him. He's okay at jiu-jitsu, so we're gonna practice some of his stuff. So all we're gonna do, we're gonna pick a side. I prefer to scoop with my left arm here. And all I'm gonna do is gable grip just above the shoulder. While I'm here, my forearm is gonna be under the chin. I'm gonna pull down here and crunch my elbow in. Really putting a pressure right behind the joint of his shoulder. Top of the shoulder, here. Because once we're here, guys, we're gonna have a couple good options. Option one is just gonna be a sweep. So we're here, grab here, rolling, pushes me down, starts six up. Crunch in, crunch the shoulder. Now, as we're here, all we're gonna do is lift up and over. Just our basic butterfly sweep. We're just starting it from bottom, and we're using the pressure off the shoulder to convince him he should pull. Because once we're here, if he really starts to stuff me, and I try to just go this way without a shoulder crunch, not a lot going on. But once I'm here, I'm going to crunch on this shoulder here and pop that chin up. And I'm going towards the side I have crunched. As I'm here, I can use that on his chin, plus the shoulder pressure to get in some better. You should let me go to mount. It'd be much better for your arm. Big things on this is just locking up that shoulder properly. Questions on this? Yeah, I'm not. So when I'm here, if I get this to mount so he crunches down on me, right? I get here. There's nothing that says I have to let go of this arm once I'm isolated. So all I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pull up and over. I can attack, I can do whatever I need to do there. That way. For me, I'm gonna keep crunching that shoulder, and then I'm gonna either attack key locks or anything of that side. I may not sit up for the arm bar directly, just because I haven't pinned down to the mat already. So unless he brings it up, I'm not gonna switch his hip bar, Kimura, Americana, any of that stuff. Right where you need to go. Other questions? Hey,
the block of the arm on the outside.
Yes, crunching is on my elbow point, so when I'm here. So when I'm here, I'm scooping up, and I'm not high elbowing this side. This side is flared down. This side flared up under his chin if possible, if not just against his chin. I don't want him looking at me. You don't look at me like me. Yeah, I want to. So basically, what I'm trying to do is all my pressure here while opposing forces. That's the goal of this shoulder crunch. I'm here. Right now, I have downward pressure here, backward pressure on the arm, and forward pressure on my elbow. A lot of moving pieces in a small area. I like it. Here, all I'm going to do, lift, follow over, and pin down. Questions on that? Yes and no. So, as far as grips go, what I'm going to prefer is going to be that, like, Captain America grip that we talk about all the time for the chokes. Now, could you go to, like, more of a forearm grip? Yes. But it's just not going to feel as natural, where that grip is going to allow for good shoulder crunch. So that's why I'm going to go to that. I've seen some people do like a wrist grip. I haven't liked it. Yeah, I don't think you can feel the difference versus that. So that's going to be more of a preferential thing. Now there's going to be some options coming off of this that I like, but all of them start with that kind of calm down grip. Questions on that? Off the palm, crunch that shoulder, take it to that side. One, two. Today we're going to be going back over that shoulder crunch we're working on. So let's assume on the butterfly with Patrick, he doesn't suck. So So he's going to flatten me out, try to kind of squish me, right? I never really appreciated this. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take one hand in for my underhook here. My other hand, I'm going to frame weight his face, setting my lock just above his shoulder. I'm going to pull that in and crunch here. Now, some of you will recognize this. A little known grappler named Gordon Bryan occasionally uses it. It's one of his better techniques. Pencil will like it. He's okay. All right. So once I'm here, I'm going to load him up and crunch here. Because what I'm trying to do is cause just enough discomfort here and across the face. And the pulling motion on this, have you guys ever seen like the close handle grip, like low pull, like seated rub? That's the type of pull I'm trying to do. Chest and back, it's not just arms. So boom, I'm framing him away here. We'll load him up and sweep towards the trapdoor. Once you're here, guys, settle into mount, attack unnecessarily. Realize your arm, the arm's going to be isolated at that point. More serious arm bar, there should be some options. Schmear, that flattens me out. And a lot of guys will do this, they'll hug to stop that forward motion, especially if you've already sat up. So if I'm here sitting back up on him, it's not going to be. Let's dig for that underhook. Boom, I'm here, framing that away from me. I'm on that hip, using that control here, because now if Pat drives into me hard or does anything, I'm in good position. Take him over. Start attacking arms, start attacking necks. Question. Biggest things on this one is making sure you're getting the pressure just above his shoulder here. Coming onto that hip and pushing it. Because I want to be able to roll across the small of my back. So when I'm here at butterfly guard, I'm never flat. I'm generally rocking from one hip to the other. So when I'm here, that allows me the motion as I pull here to extend and take pad over. He pushes into me. Okay, I got my underhook. Boom, I break up. This hand under the chin or across the jaw, that's a preference. I generally like to pop the chin up just because it gives me head control. Some guys just want to push away from them. That's a preferential thing. I like, especially on this one, to pop the chin up because it makes taking them that way easier. Once, the way I heard it best described, you've done a low hand, like most handles, where you're pulling that in and opening up your chest. That's the same thing you're doing here when you're pulling this in. But now we're going to assume that James doesn't suck at jiu-jitsu. So he's going to have one or two reactions, right? So I get here, I start to lock down on his shoulder, right? Two options. He's either going to look away and try to sneak this arm out, or he's going to push in deeper and try to like lock his hands. Like he's here, he's going to try to lock down. Two immediate, not bad options of how to respond. So we're going to work on the first option. He tries to sneak his arm out and away from me. I'm going to lock down on this shoulder here. He's going to try to start to straighten his arm and bring it out. We're just going to hit one of my favorite submissions, that reverse arm lock. So all we're going to do is shift our hips slightly so that we're not flat, we're on our side. Our hand's going to move from the shoulder to the top of his elbow. And we're going to very gently and very slowly, because we're all friends here, pull down on that while we're entering our toe. There's a lot of friction in here. The jam itself quite a bit. And all you're really doing is shifting your hip and dragging that lock in. So as I'm here, he starts to pull out. You feel me? That same lock web is
Head down. Just from the elbow. Bitch, can you answer your telephone? I nod so that it's not tight on James' arm, and it's still tight. When I'm here, I also extend it out just that little bit, and it's tight. So the only big shift you have to do is your hips. Your arm will actually land where it needs to be if you keep pressure. So while I'm here, all I'm doing is keeping pressure on this. He goes to pull out. All I'm going to do is be here, put it in my ear, and it'll be there. Little shifts, because he's already going to be walking away. So what a lot of guys try to do when they see this happen, because it may or may not be a popular movement. Corner eye does it, therefore it's important. A lot of people have found out, especially Nogi, you can look away, get that arm down and in, and start to get out. Reaction, especially in the pajamas where you have some friction and some time. Yeah.
The arm will kind of roll.
Yeah.
You catch it with your head and neck.
You know the limp arm out drill we do sometimes? That's the drill he's trying to run. He's trying to limp arm his way through. All you're doing is catching it midway. Does that make sense? Questions on this one? Yeah. I'm going to answer it two ways. Yes and yes. So, if I know I'm not, so let's say I'm going to face a bigger guy and I don't want that. I'm going to set this up to stay on bottom. Let's say I'm trying to get him out and he tries to pull his arm away. Then I hit him. So it's going to depend on what you're trying to do and what works. I'm always attacking that reverse arm lock if I'm in butterfly guard. Just know if I'm in butterfly guard, that is on the options bar every time. Because I love it. Because a lot of people try to grab my head and pass this, do that little pass. And all I wait for them to do is fuck that up. And I fuck it. Every time, I love it. It makes my day. So, am I going to be a step ahead of them and set it up like that? May I give him a little space to try to get his arm out? Maybe. Or, hey, I'm trying to hit that speed. He fucks up and straightens that arm. Let's hit. So, yes and yes.
This is kind of like a preliminary question when you're in there. You can say, like, I don't know, I'm just kind of curious about how you can get your leg over and go to like an open.
Oh, yes. If I'm here, the ideal position to finish this reverse arm block is actually this leg tight here and this knee on top. That is actually the ideal. Like if you're setting up just that, that's where I'm trying to get. Would I be in a hurry to kick my leg out there? No, because I'm still going to be trying to hunt that butterfly guard a lot. So it just depends on what you're trying to do. Yeah, if I'm here, I try to shoulder crunch. He goes to come out and I get here. Not gonna fit me. I like having that top. So really just depends on what. Into my chest, let him come forward. Would you tap? All I want is arms in my chest. To your side on your ribs. Now there's a gap. I can put his elbow through the mat if I want. Not going to, because most days I do like James. Occasionally he makes me, but make sure you're not attaching this thing to your chest. Off to your side, wrist in the ear, and if his elbow's pointed a funky way, guys, realize you can manipulate that. Finish. And for those of you who know the hornbuckle finish, if it is in a weird spot, C cup grip it, adjust. And when you do that with hornbuckle, who has 85 inch reach, it's absurd. His arms, his elbow's like 6 inches higher, and then he pushes it down real violent. So make sure that lock is off your chest. Does that make sense? And then if you need to, adjust that elbow so that his thumb's pointed down. So if his thumb's pointed down and I put pressure, that works. But if his thumb's pointed that way and I put pressure, it may hurt. But it's not where it needs to be. So I have to adjust that lock. Boom. That works. Make sense? Wrap up those details. 1, 2, 3. So now I'm here with Patrick, and I get to hear, and I get the shoulder crunch position, and there's only a couple good reactions. One is going to be the turn away and try to, like, limp arm this arm. You know, he's going to try to start bringing it down, digging for that underhook, doing something so that I don't have this arm and shoulder attack. So once I'm here, he's going to start to pull away from me, which I don't mind. I'm going to just come onto my side. And I'm going to cheat my knee up on top of his back if I can. Good suck in, don't worry about it. I'm going to get it up here a little bit. All we're going to do at that point, answer our telephone like that asshole at Starbucks. Go like, try to keep his wrist.
Put a cell phone here.
My hand, I'm going to put the blade of my wrist right behind his elbow. Here, pulling down. Couple big details with this one, guys. One, do not pull this quickly. This one has a very quick pop rate. It's either in or it's not. So if you pull a little bit and you don't see that little like action, it's not in. Don't just pull hard. Literally, that's all the pressure it takes to get through. So if you're not getting that, adjust your lock, adjust your position. Two, do not block your own lock. One of the big things that we do in this one a lot is you guys will lay flat on your back and you'll be like, I'm breaking Pat's arm. No, you're pushing it into your chest, asshole. Shift to your side. See how that creates a nice little vacuum space right here? Makes it much easier. Alright. The other thing, if his thumb is pointed up, then I have to drive his arm up. So if I want to pull his arm down, I need his thumb pointed down. Now, if his thumb isn't where you need it to be, top bottom hand, rotate. Works a lot better. Questions on this? I'll walk through it a couple more times. Get my underhook here. I'm starting to shoulder crunch. He doesn't like it. He starts to pull his arm out. All I'm doing, guys, trapping my knee on top of his back, trapping that wrist, grabbing here. Now, if you can't get this grip right, I prefer this grip quite a bit. There is another option. C cup his elbow right here. Rotate it to where you need it to be. Grab your top elbow, push down. Hornbuckle taught me that. It's one of the nastiest ways I've ever seen one finish it, but it's also because he has 12 foot long arms. He's got an absurd wingspan. Questions on this one. You guys have seen this reverse arm lock before if you've been here a while. This is just my favorite position to hit it from. Alright. Questions, comments, concerns? 1, 2, 3. All right. So I'm here, right? And he doesn't suck at jiu-jitsu, so he pushes me down. I go to shoulder crunch, right? But he still doesn't suck, so he's going to pressure in and try to crowd me and lock his hands here. I don't really appreciate that. Two reasons. One, it makes a lot of things really difficult. And two, it's a lot of pressure on me because a lot of guys will start getting on their toes here. Okay. Not convenient, right? All we're going to do, I'm going to, as he drives up, duck your head out. Keep your hand locked. Shift him away from you and take the back. That looks complex, and a lot of you are going to overthink the room on this. It is easier than it looks. James is going gonna fuck this up. He's gonna overthink the shit out of it. I'm gonna love it. So he's here, he's crunching in. All we're gonna do is get our head out to the side. Then all we're gonna do, guys, shift him out, put our hook in. Take the back. Really helpful when a guy's driving into hard, especially. That's when it works best. Because if I'm here and James is really driving into me, driving in and locking his hands. Create just enough space and pull him forward. Get my head out the hole. All I'm going to do then, crunch down on this arm and pull him to the side. So I'm pulling him this way while I do that.
Everybody that missed, can you help with his elbow to drive his face up to get his head under there? I really think that he's using his arm to help get space on this guy.
See how that's there? That helps. Cool. As I'm driving him this way, this hook kicks him over. See how that hooks that back leg? Hooks it. Come around. Grab pajamas. Take the back. We're here. He drives into me. Out, over. Then as I'm kicking him over, this leg kicks him over, and then hooks back in. Then you can either go to half back or start diving that second one. I'm going to get to my backpack quickly, then it's take the back of that. No. You may get sweet points, but you're not going to get back points until that second one crosses the hit.
Or body lock, right?
Well, no, body lock. So, IBJJF, because we're prepping for the end of next month, body lock does not score as back. You have to have both hooks over the medial line of the thigh. I looked up the ruling. So, thigh bones here, right? Pass to pass, the middle, both feet, 4 seconds. Body lock does not count. Yeah, literally, you know why guys turtle and do that? Because that's fucking cool.
Wow. I mean, it sets him up for the joke, so I mean, it's not the worst for you, but still, it's a point.
The McFuckery is still done. One more time. Any other questions on this? I like this little back attack because I hate overzealous people who try to smush me. There's a lot of dudes try to smush me and think it's going to help. Create my space. Up and around. Once I'm here, take the back. Once you're here, guys, James is apparently going to let me choke him out like that, which is great. I appreciate it. Questions? Drill her out.
Yeah, everybody.
You were right behind me.
Yeah. All right. So when you get your head out, before you click, are you just keeping both legs?
Yeah, I'm keeping. And so what I'm going to do here, as I'm here, I'm using that to create space and keeping that butterfly hook. Because if he goes real crazy here, I still want to be able to regard. So let's say James is still a spazzy white belt. He's not, he's a blue belt now. So he kind of spazzes here. I want to be able to maintain some options here. Where if I just, I may or may not have
it. And Jordan probably is that head higher than the elbow, so he can't cheat that elbow back in front. That's going to happen.
When I'm here, I'm just keeping my head tight.
Can't slip that elbow back around, right?
Because even if he does slip that elbow back through,
well,
I'm not.
Got your shoulder, Brian.
Yeah, I'm not upset about it. So if I'm here and he starts dragging that elbow through, you can have other fun options.
Don't be like you there.
It's lots of fun for butterfly guys, so I love you all. Questions? One, two, three! get to here, right? And Pat even jokingly said, I don't pull my arm out here because I know this is, that arm lock is one of my favorite submissions. I try to hit it from everywhere, whenever I can. So Pat realizes that. So what's he going to do? He's going to bunch into me and try to lock his hands here. Great. All we're going to do is just a little sneaky back take from here. All I'm going to do, I'm going to extend everything up. Then I'm going to duck my head in this little hole right here. Pulling down. Push, pull. As we're here, lock, hold, grab a piece of something up here. Like you're cupping the shoulder, grabbing the cloth, grabbing some collar. I don't care what you grab. Grab something in the shoulder-ish region. Shift out and extend him away from you.
Uh-oh.
With your bottom leg. That'll set him in here. Lap. Can you get that? So I'm here. I get here. Pat doesn't like what's happening, so he starts to lock his hand and try to crush it. That's great. Boom. Duck out. Push him away. Shifting out behind him. Here. Work to take back. Biggest thing is coming through that hole and then tightening back down. So when I come through that, so as I come here, I get here. The big thing I noticed from you guys Tuesday, a lot of you guys were pretty loose once you came back through here. I'm trying to put my ear on the back of his shoulder. Because now if he tries to turn into me hard, shift him out, come around the back. Quick little back take. Like I said, the nice part about this one is a lot of guys, when you start to attack this, don't like shoulder pressure. So if I start putting pressure on Pat here, he's going to crush me. Try to get me so he can hit the stand and pass, do some other things. All we're gonna do is beat him to that punch, that little bit. Here. Remember, for IBJJF purposes, do not cross your feet and do not body lock until you've got your balls. Questions on this? Yep. So I'm framing him up just that little bit, because all I'm trying to create is a hole to duck into. So he's going to be trying to smoosh here, right? A little bit of a hole right here. So I'm always trying to use that form against the face to frame him off. So think about it this way. If Pat's got good pressure on me here, right? I'm not going to be able to duck under there. But if I can create a little space. You can after you get your points. So, jiu-jitsu, you gotta get both hooks in. Or, then you do whatever the hell you want to do. But, you wanna make sure we're scoring and he's on top. Other questions? Once I'm here, this isn't a hangout position. This hand, I'm looking for hip, I'm looking for pants, far side collar, because I want something to help me turn. So I'm really not holding this grip long. The second my head gets back here, I'm looking, this hand, got to grab a hold of something over here. What that's going to be is going to be a game time, reach and grab something. Best case, you grab some pants and it turns their hips into you. Worst case, you grab their shoulder even. I don't get something. So I'm not hanging out there long. So the second I duck, boom, I'm here. I have to go. Because if I just hang out here, he's going to start biting his arm back in, setting his hips back. So this is a 1-2 punch back there. 1-2. It's not a 1-2. It's a 5-10. I'll have time to hang out. questions on that? We're out. One, two, three. Things are going well. Boom, I get the shoulder crunch. Let's say I go to shoulder crunch here, and I just can't seem to get it. He's either posting up, he's backing his hips off, something's happening where I can't get him pulled in well, right? All we're gonna do now is attack the arm. So I'm here, he starts to kind of back out. My right leg in this instance is gonna come up to the armpit. All I'm gonna do, up, pull the arm. So I'm here with Hackett, he's attacking, I can't get him over. Here, I back my arm out. Here, here. As soon as my heel comes across his face, it arcs back. Back straight arm.
A lot of dumb people are gonna circle there too, you making your leg going over the face even easier.
A lot of people will walk into this. Yeah. That's why I like it. So I'm here with Jake. I'm here, I start the shoulder crunch. For whatever reason, my pressure isn't right. I can't get the lock. I'm not physically stronger than James. But I'm here, and I can't seem to get it open. I'm gonna go to this side. I'm gonna pull out and open. Now, realize, this arm bar will not be tight for long. I don't have control of his body, and I really don't have a good attachment on the arm. Two options. The second he hits his back, fall up. Secure yourself in a little bit better, fall down. Or, as soon as he hits, attack. That's going to be a game plan and timing choice. That's a tactical decision, not a technical decision. Does everyone get what I mean? When I say tactical versus technical. Tactical are decisions you make in fight. Technical is the way you do it. Questions on this? We'll walk through it a few more times. Yeah, here's the thing. The reason I like this option. I have this arm. Let's say I go to escape this, and James goes to walk this way. He walks in. If he walks towards the open side, I can still get it. If he walks to the closed side, so let's say I'm here, he goes to walk towards the closed side, he walks into the sweep better. Either way, he walks into it to an extent. Worst case scenario, you end up inside, guys. Shoot or shoot. This isn't no
good.
Questions on this? Sometimes you suck at jiu-jitsu, alright, drill her out. One, two, three. Alright, so one drill we do every day, guys. How many of you have sat here and been like, man, I wonder why we do that drill? It's almost like we do an inversion drill like that to be able to come back in. It's a real fun technique. I'm here sitting up, I invert, come back. That's the technical motion that you're getting. You just have a body in your way. So when I'm here, I'm sitting him back up just enough so that when I invert, come back. How many of you are feeling bad about yourself for not being able to hit this move? Congrats, unless you're a purple belt, you shouldn't. Purple belt level move. If you're missing this, realize you should be. Don't beat yourself up on this. This is a complex movement designed for complex people. Questions, honestly. I told them that earlier and they laughed. And I can see Carolyn's face, like, I hate Dustin for not saying that earlier. Realize if you're like, how do I exit butterfly guard, invert into an arm bar. Which part of that sounds like a white belt technique? So guys, realize some techniques I'm showing that are going to apply to everyone and everyone should be able to grab. Right? That basic shoulder crunch sweep, the room should be able to get, right? Short of maybe you seem like a nice guy, but I don't know if you've grappled. So, but things like that, but realize the deeper into the technical series we get, there's going to be times where I just look at white belts and I say, look, I'm sorry, that's really not designed for you. Focus on the other things. James has been here, what, 2 years? You've seen me do that. I mean, but being exposed to those things and then being able to pick them back up later down the road always gets still there. Questions on anything we worked on today? We're going to expand on it Thursday, but go ahead, mouth these things, quick drink of water, let's get back ready for some savagery. 1, 2. We worked an armbar option on this. So boom, I'm here, and we worked on what happens if you take an armbar. We seem to struggle with that quite a bit. So today, we're going to do that same peek out over here. All I'm going to do though, instead of trying to sweep or do anything crazy, I'm going to sit him up. As I'm here, sit back. It's a very aggressive one. So boom, I'm here, I'm poking him up. Boom, I'm going to sit up with him. He's naturally going to drive back into me. Top of the chin. Question. If you can, yes. So, down here. In an ideal world, with this leg come out? Yes. Close to the top, you're not going to get it. It's so fast because of the positioning. Big thing with this one, guys. Cupping that chin, grabbing the belly part of the hand, turning the chin up. Any other questions? Same as our traditional guillotine grip, that palm-to-palm grip I like, is it allows you to cup that chin with your bottom hand and roll. But when I'm here, the only big difference is where your head is positioned.
On this one, I've just got his shoulder kind of manipulated. So that's going to be a lot of time for you.
Most guys are going to be good enough, they're going to drop this arm behind or start trying to do something. And if it is, this one's pretty quick. And if they get their arm in front of your face, you can still finish this. Other questions? Driller out. One, two, three.